Welcome to Soaping 101. As a beginner soap maker, I was obsessed with soap recipes. Why use this oil and not another one? How can I change my recipe to make my soap harder, creamier, bubblier, or more cleansing? Well, it's all due to the structure of the soap oil. Let's dive into what makes an oil a good one for your recipe by meeting the players. The most common oils we use for soap making contain linoleic acid, stearic acid, lauric acid, palmitic acid, oleic acid, myristic acid, linolenic acid, and ricinoleic acid. Each acid imparts specific qualities to the oil and, in turn, to your soap recipe. Lauric and myristic contribute to hardness, cleansing, and bubbles. Palmitic and stearic acids lend hardness and creaminess properties. Linoleic, linolenic, and oleic acids are conditioners. And ricinoleic acid imparts conditioning properties, bubbleness, and creaminess. Now that we know the players, let's see how they work together. Let's use castor oil as an example. Castor oil is made up in large part of 90% ricinoleic acid, 4% linoleic acid, and 4% oleic acid. Looks great. If I could just use castor in my recipe, my skin would be so conditioned with creamy bubbles. But not so fast. There's definitely something that we're missing. Where are the hardness and cleansing properties? If we input castor oil's percentage makeup into chart form, we can see that using our recipe that only consists of 1 ounce of castor oil will have 0% hardness and 0% cleansing. Just imagine a goopy soap. Now let's use coconut oil as an example. Coconut oil is made up in large part of 48% lauric acid, 19% myristic acid, 9% palmitic acid, 3% stearic acid, 8% oleic acid, and 2% linoleic acid. Now we seem to be getting somewhere. We have both the hardness and the cleansing we were looking for. It should be perfect, but it's not. By looking at our chart for coconut oil, we can see that nearly 75% of our recipe is just hardness, cleansing, and bubbly. Sure, we have a little bit of creaminess, but a small percentage of conditioning properties. That's the nature of a pure coconut oil soap. Hard as a rock and ultra cleansing. So much so that it can clean away the natural layer of oils on our skin. We need another oil. Let's use olive oil for our next example. Olive oil is made up in large part of 13% palmitic acid, 3% stearic acid, 69% oleic acid, 12% linoleic acid, and 1% linolenic acid. Perfect! We have an ultra-conditioning bar that is also firm. But if you've ever used 100% olive oil soap, you may notice that it lacks bubbles and may feel a little slimy. This is because olive oil lacks cleansing and bubbling abilities. What would happen if we brought the whole group of oils together to act as a team? The fatty acid properties synergize. All the boxes are checked, and we have created a well-balanced blend. With the exception of one thing, we're certainly not going to make a 3-ounce oil soap. So let's change the ratio to reflect our tried and true Soaping 101 Bastille recipe. Now that's much better. There are so many oils to try in your recipes, and these are just a few to get you to understand how and why they work together or apart. Once you understand, I know that you'll be a better educated soap maker. Science can be seriously fun. I hope I have briefly made you want to know more before you soap. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time.